I don't know about you, but at this point, just feels like Lin-Manuel Miranda is stacking up songs to get all the nominations come Oscar season. And you know what? He might deserve them. This is my review of Vivo. We follow Vivo, a music-loving Kinkajou from Cuba who embarks on the journey of a lifetime to Miami to fulfill his destiny and deliver a love song for an old friend. Now, before I start with my thoughts, I want to know if you're excited for Vivo and how do you rank the animated movies of 2021 thus far? Drop it all in the comments below, start the conversation, it's always the most important part. And while you're down there, if you're new to the channel, first of all, thank you so much for clicking on this video. Why don't you consider clicking the subscribe button? It helps the channel a lot to put the content out there, and you'll join a beautiful film fan community. Vivo is a joyous adventure filled with catchy songs and vibrant looking animation. I love the look of this film, and I love the simplicity to it. I think this film just visually conveys a lot of emotion. It conveys a lot of its territory. When you're down in Havana in Cuba, you just feel like you're there. When you're in Miami, you see all the beauty of it and sometimes the not as pretty things that are there, especially when our characters go through the Everglades. Visually, it's just stunning to look at. It captures all its landscapes just beautifully and uniquely, honestly. And Vivo is just such a lovable character. An obviously tragic backstory because he is this little cute Kinkajou, and it always helps if your character is an animal. I will always, always root for you. This character is just so well done. He's got a beautiful arc that he goes through in this film. His friendship with his owner Andres is just gorgeous. It's emotional, it's beautiful, it's touching, and the film pulls a fast one you about 17 minutes into the film that I did not expect. And Vivo has to go deliver this letter that he wrote long ago to a person that he loved, and he has to go from Cuba to Miami, and he finds help in this niece of Andres that he meets, and she's the complete opposite for him. Vivo is amazing at doing music. He understands melody and how music works. He's very lively, but he's also very afraid because he never knew anything, nor did he want to know anything besides his owner and the friendship that they shared. But this little girl brings out something new in him and gives him something that he desperately needed. And I love how these characters truly complement each other. And not just because the script says so. These characters go, emotionally speaking, on a beautiful journey and get to understand one another, and they give one another something they desperately needed, even if they didn't realize it themselves. The music is also extremely catchy. There are some really, really great songs in this film, some of the standouts of the year. And again, Lin-Manuel is just stacking up all these movie songs. He's gonna get them all. I don't know, probably not, but he probably deserves it, man. These songs are really good, really catchy. They truly transmit the feeling of the locations of the film and the feeling of these characters, obviously, but they truly speak to what these characters learn throughout their journey. But there are definitely also some songs that do not stick the landing. They're not particularly bad or anything, they just don't stand out, and sometimes they sound too much like the same. I think the film does a little too many encores of songs that I've already played, and I think it needed a little more time to breathe sometimes between songs. I think the film spacing is really hurt because we get all those encores that we did not need whatsoever. And sometimes the silent moments in this movie are truly what works best. Even with it being a musical, some pauses, or some more pauses in this case, in between the musical moments would have really, really helped. There are like 4 or 5 songs that I could cut out of this film. The ones that are good, really freaking good. The ones that aren't, they're insignificant, I'd say, to the point where you can cut them out and you don't lose anything. And speaking of how the pacing is hurt, this film has some really good buildup from some truly incredible emotional moments, and when they're there, they're good, but they quickly vanish away so the film can move on to something else. The film runs at 95 minutes. I think you could have gone for 1 hour 45 easily. Because when you have such build-up and such good build-up at that, you want to linger on with these characters in certain moments of catharsis, of realization, of learning something new that is important to them. And I think the film just moves way too quickly past those not to let them linger on. There's one moment, the 17-minute mark earlier in the film, where you just sit there. And it's somber, and it's potent, and it really hits you. Apart from that, cherish all those little seconds that you get to the payoffs throughout the film, because they don't last too long, unfortunately. And this is a very nitpicky nitpick, but the film had one scene too many. There was a perfect moment for this film to close out. It had a perfect scene, it had a perfect shot to end it on, it fades out, and then we have one more scene that I think should have just played as the credits rolled. I think it would have worked much, much better to give that final note where the film truly earned it and needed it, to be honestly. Even with all those issues, Vivo is a joyous film to watch. Super entertaining, welcoming to families and kids alike. It has some really good lessons, charming characters to no end. Again, you're going to have an animal as your main character. He has an incredible arc throughout this film, a beautiful friendship with his owner and with the niece of his owner that forms throughout the film. An amazing voice cast, by the way. Some really catchy songs. It's for sure a recommend, a definite good watch. I'm giving Vivo a B. And those are my thoughts on Vivo. Let me know your thoughts about it down below. If you've seen it, if not, are you excited for it? And don't forget to let me know what is your favorite animated movie so far this year. Thank you so much for watching. You are the best. I'll be back very soon with many more reviews. One of them I'm very excited to share with you on Thursday. And I hope to see you there. And so until then, love each other and love the movies.